You are welcome to my channel. Ahead in this video, we will be looking at how you can create user accounts on your CCTV camera system to protect your system from unauthorized assets. I will also be showing you how you can put limits on the created user accounts in order to restrict the kind of activities that can be performed or carried out by a particular user. Lastly, I will be disclosing in this video one trade secret that you can adopt to easily retrieve lost or forgotten client IDs and passwords to CCTV camera systems. If this is your first time here on this channel, please subscribe and turn on your notifications so you can be notified of new videos that will be posted on this channel. Let's begin by looking at how you can create a user account on your CCTV camera system. You will have to first access the main menu by right-clicking on your screen and then move to System Setup. Then choose Users. This is where you can create the user accounts. But note that there are two types of user groups you will find on every CCTV camera system. There is the local user, and then there is also the network user. The local user refers to those that will be physically accessing the CCTV system, or you can also call them the in-house users, whilst the network users are those that will log on to the CCTV system remotely from either a computer or any mobile device. So let's create a local user account and then add. At this point, you have the opportunity to create a username and a password of your choice, which you will be required to enter whenever you want to access any information on your CCTV system. So let me try to create an account for the purpose of this study. I will name it Test. The password is 123, and then enter. Quite apart from the username and password, there are functions you can allow or disallow the user of this account to perform. And that brings me to the second objective of this video, which is to show you how you can put limits or restrictions on the kind of activities that a particular person can perform through his user account he has been assigned. All these functions you see listed below here can either be restricted or made available to the user of this account. They are all a form of restriction or otherwise that you can place on the user of this user account. All you need to do to activate any of them is to check the particular one you wish to allow, or you can allow all by clicking on all and then OK. So you can see that the account has been created with username as Test. You will observe that the system allows for multiple user accounts to be created on the same machine. And that is a good point to introduce my third objective, which is to reveal a trade secret to help you easily retrieve lost or forgotten client user IDs and passwords. As a trade secret, what I normally do to retrieve clients' lost or forgotten IDs and passwords is to create what I call administrator accounts on my clients' CCTV systems. And that I do when I'm doing the initial setup of their systems. So for instance, on this system, I would have created a user account that I will label admin with a password which I keep for all my clients and can always remember without fail. And because I will want that account to be unrestricted, I allow all features active by choosing all. In the event that the client loses his login details, like in an example where this Test account password is forgotten, as a result of that, you have this inscription, incorrect password or username. All I will do is to log in using the administrator account whose password I have kept. Login. Now that I'm able to log in, I'll then edit the user account whose password was forgotten. So I will choose that account and then move to edit. At this point, I will edit the password to a new password and maintain the username. So I'll put in a password of the client's choice and then confirm it. We can confirm what we have done, whether it works, by logging out of the system and then use the old login username and a new password. And you will realize that it works perfectly. Please note that you can create user accounts for network users as well. The process is similar to the creation of local user accounts. Right-click on your screen, System Setup. I'm giving CCTV as the username. Password 9949. And then select the functions that can be performed by this account. You can choose to allow any of these functions or allow all of these functions. And then create the account by clicking OK. With what we have done, we have just successfully created a remote view access account with username CCTV and password 9949, which will be required whenever you want to access your system or your CCTV system on a mobile phone or any device online.